Do you have faith? Most above all, we should be looking at our actions because they tell us the most about ourselves. The evidence that I really have it is the fruit. And that's what James is saying. Discovered that the Bible doesn't teach justification by professing faith, but it teaches justification by actually having faith.
And the Father's plan of salvation, it involves more than just God taking us to heaven when we die. So that implies that it's not according to our intelligence. It's not according to how well we speak. I have to submit to him. I got to cooperate with him to see that change in my life because we have the grace to be like him.
We should not be people who have theologies, our beliefs built on just glancing at scripture, okay? Paul says, this is how you become a Christian. James says, this is what being a Christian should mean in your life.
Whatever you have for me, God, I'm all in with your plan. It's not according to how well we understand things with the natural mind, but it's according to the power of God that works inside of the believer.
We're supposed to dig and pray and study and think. When we say we trust God, when we say we believe God, when we say we have faith in God, we do the Bible.
That as a believer, I have to cooperate with God for him to change me because we have the grace to be like him. We have to get familiar with the word of God. We have to make time to know God's word because knowing God's word is to know his will.
Profession means that a claim has been made. I profess to be a Christian. I am making a claim.
Paul is saying, since God has been this good to you, that this is what you should do. You should at least walk worthy of your calling, or in other words, live up to it.